रंग शोष पैरेंट एलिमेंट एंड मैप एलिमेंट कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ मैपिंग इसे पैरामेट्रिक एलिमेंट ट्रायंगुलर एलिमेंट्स एंड प्लेन रेक्टेंगुलर एलिमेंट मैप्ड रेक्टेंगुलर एलिमेंट्स इट्स शोस लाइक दिस पैरेंट बिग एलिमेंट पैरेंट क्यूब एलिमेंट एंड मैप्ड बिग एलिमेंट द मेथड ऑफ कोऑर्डिनेट ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम नेचुरल कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम इनटू ग्लोबल कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम शेप फंक्शन एंड स्टिफनेस मैट्रिक्स फॉर फोर नोडेड कोऑर्डिनेट न्यूमेरिकल डिविजन्स आर सेंटर्ड So there is a parametric element and the nodes as well as displacements are specified. The nodes used for defining the geometry nodes specified by dog dot line and the triangle is specified to define the displacements. All the 8 nodes are used in defining geometry as well as displacement. If the number of nodes used for defining the geometry is same as number of nodes used for defining the displacements, then it's known as isoparametric element. Then superparametric element, it shows like this. It have a number of displacements, it's very limited one. But the nodes are specified in all such points. Next is superparametric element. The nodes used for defining geometry. Generally, nodes used for defining the geometry. Then nodes used for triangular nodes used for defining displacements. The nodes used for defining geometry as well as displacements. 8 nodes are used to define the geometry and 4 nodes used for defining displacements. If the number of nodes used for defining the geometry is more than number of nodes used for defining the displacements, then it is known as superparametric element. Then superparametric element, it's also like this. It's based on number of nodes and displacements. Based upon that, we can categorize into isoparametric element, superparametric element. Finally, we are discussing subparametric element. Here also same specifications, nodes as well as displacements at all. 4 nodes are used to define the geometry and 8 nodes are used to define the displacements. So displacement as well as nodes are defined very clearly. If the number of nodes used for defining the geometry is less than the number of nodes and for defining the displacement, then it is known as subparametric element. So the things are available here. Based upon that, we need to find out the what category the element comes under, whether it may be isoparametric or subparametric or the superparametric, whatever may be. In isoparametric, the count of nodes as well as displacements would be equal, whereas in superparametric element So number of nodes specified on the diagram is more, but the displacements are very limited comparing the node numbers specified here. So super parametric means carrying it up like this. So this is the thing, since superparametric number of nodes are specified more, the displacements are very limited. Then subparametric is just opposite of the superparametric, where the node points are very limited, but the displacements are specified in a greater rate. So these are the differences between the isoperimetric, superparametric and subparametric at all.